Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome to a new series that we're going to be trying out. This is a build study. So if you don't know what that is, it's like an art study. And if you don't know what that is, an art study is where you take someone else's work, right? And you attempt to recreate it. You draw it and you try to figure out what techniques that the person that made it is using. And a build study is just like that. I am taking somebody else's build, shown here, which I found on Reddit by the user, I think it's DanCSA222. And it's just something I found. I liked it, and I kind of wanted to know some of the techniques that he used. And I'm going to be building it, and as I build it, I'm going to be learning what he did. And hopefully the idea is that I can take those techniques and apply them to my own techniques and use them in the future, learn more about building. And I'm going to be going in depth about what I see, what I'm learning as I build it. So just to get into it, let's get back in first person view. And to start off, I'm just going to lay down the foundation. So the first thing that I noticed already that I don't do is where I would normally build like this to introduce depth into the build by creating depth into the wall. This building is large enough that he's actually just creating depth between walls and keeping that surface between the support beams and the walls flat, and then from there he adds in smaller objects to create depth. So just to rewind that, instead of this sort of function, he goes with this sort of function. The next thing that I notice, I'm going to pull up the picture again here so that you can see the finished product. And by the way, link below in the description to these actual images so that you can see them. Pull them up while we're doing this, while we're talking, so you can see what I'm talking about in the finished product. But there's a transition in pretty much every building between the first floor and the second floor. In a lot of cases, what I will do is I will bring the wall out another step and then find a way to transition from this wall to this wall, which in a lot of cases will be stairs underneath to make a more gradual transition. What he actually does is he creates a barrier with a very tiny roof line, which doesn't seem to actually serve any purpose other than shade. Now, this is nothing new to me, continuing to frame the wall with wood, but he does tuck in some logs down here. And this looks like this is actually going to be hidden in his build, which takes away from the fact, and this is good that it takes away, it hides the fact that this is connected to this, these two different directions of logs. So that just shows that there is a wood surface behind this little faux roof line. And then once again, this isn't going to be tucked back. But what I do notice, and let's raise this up, to create the concept, not concept, the kind of an illusion that it's tucked away, he has a baseline on all of his windows on this level. Underneath these windows, he has this little trim line of stairs that does set it in half a block, just temporarily. Once again, setting is kind of like, if we look at these two, let's put in the rest of this floor here. And he uses a second type of wood, which is oak wood, to differentiate itself from this roof line. But so we see our first floor here and we see our second floor here, and it's cut off by almost three different things: this roof line, this wood trim, and then this indent with also a differing material. So within two blocks of height, we create a lot of little depth and a lot of differentiation just between three different materials and this little step in. Another interesting thing that he does here is where this wall is going to come straight up, just like the last wall. Pretty much the exact same pattern. In fact, that's going to come back another one, I think, like that. And then my first thought was to bring this one back to match this wall, but he actually continues it like this and then brings up a support like this. Now that creates an awkward situation between four different pillars meeting up right here. And the way that he actually fixes that is he sends one sticking straight out and he uses a trap door. So that's very useful, very interesting to me. That definitely makes it blend together. See, if we were to just keep this, it just looks like this big conglomeration of wood, and it doesn't seem to make much sense structurally. But this looks like it has a centralized pillar, and all these pillars are meeting up into it. And then I'm going to assume that this one is the same way without looking. And then that allows us to have these two walls on the same plane while still having depth here. And that brings up lots of interesting possibilities and effects. So let me just lay these out, then we can talk about that. So there's a few interesting things to me here. And let's actually get the windows in place. Window? No, that's not what it's called. Glass panes. I really don't like white. So let's go with gray and put them in. So, hello, my shaders don't want to work very well with that, I guess, so I'm just going to leave them out. So, when I build something, I like to really keep in mind how you're going to view it if you're actually walking around. So, buildings, for the most part, are usually going to be pretty flat on one wall. They could have some dramatic turns looking above, some dramatic turns like this and this, so that creates some 90 degree angles, but most houses aren't going to slant like this unless you're really getting into a different, unique style. And that's, you know, it's a whole different thing. But roads aren't always like that, right? Roads can go like this, correct? What this allows me to do in my eyes is you've got two dimensions. So the house up here is working on X and Y axes, staying straight with both of those axes. Meanwhile, down here, you don't have to work on that axes. And it's just little things that kind of are cool to see. And I think you take for granted. See, I'm walking this way and I'm getting closer and closer to the building, or I'm walking this way and I'm kind of getting further from the building, right? Whereas if I were walking parallel to it, you don't really get that depth. And it's something that you don't really think about. It's something that when you step back and look at a build, you're not going to get that. You're not going to realize it. But it's there. It definitely is. Another thing I noticed, when he has two different blocks like this, he continues to do this sort of thing. So that just adds more detail to that roof line, which got a little boring over here otherwise. And then he doesn't continue the roof line over here. Now, just using the styles that I've gotten from this builder so far, he could have very easily continued on with the theme just like this. That would have worked perfectly fine, in my opinion. However, what he does instead, let's get those trapdoors back, right? Get that back on here. We're not going to be using that glass because my shaders are out of date. What he does instead is he puts them... Looks like he puts them down here, which is something I do. I'll do stuff like this. And then that adds another level of this roof line. It changes up this roof line and brings it down, which this isn't a roof line, but it's the same structure, so it may as well be. Same material. I've gone ahead and put a stone wall behind us so I can put in those windows without that weird effect, and because windows are important. So that actually brings in a fourth level of depth on this line here. So we have our roof. Well, I shouldn't say that. We have our roof. We have these stairs. We have this wood trim. We have this different material with a step in, and then we have this. So what I'm learning from this, kind of repeating myself again, normally I'm inclined to do this with my building. That's a whole block stepping in, and then you can use whole blocks alternating between there. You'll have blocks like this, and you'll switch back and forth like that. Just like generalizing with stone bricks here, but just patterns zigzagging in and out on a full block spectrum. Here, he's got blocks zigging in and out on a half block spectrum, which, I mean, I still use stairs, I still use window panes and stuff, but he's maximizing that here, I think. So, another thing that I've noticed here is this isn't enough detail here. So what he actually does, and this is more of a personal preference thing, I'm not sure that I'm a huge fan of this, and let's lay it out to see. So I don't mind that. And then he does this and puts that in there. Now, it looks nice for adding detail. Now, I'm looking at the picture again. And in the grand scheme of things, you're not zeroing in on this at all. You're looking at the parts where it does cut in at 90 degrees here and goes back three blocks or whatever. You're not really zeroing in on this. But when I do zero in on this little thing here, I'm not sure that I like this detail. So that's really up to the builder, I think. I'm going to look to see. Maybe I can find an alternative that works for me. I've actually come up with a number of things here that I'm going to try. The first thing is going to be, you could put something like that if you want to incorporate your town flag into it. Remove that, actually, I would say. We could take this and not do that, but that. And then that could always look good. That puts in some bright color is the main thing, and that can be good, definitely. And I like to work in my flag colors into my buildings, so it could work, but as a structural component, not really. It's, it could go both ways. Then you could do something like this. I'm actually a little bit partial maybe to that. If I really don't care for this texture, I am using a default texture for that, and I'm really not that keen on this texture with these holes. It looks like a very dated texture to me. So if you're using like B-Dub's texture pack, where he actually makes it into this texture, I believe, like half of this door, then I think that would look really good. But that's up to you again. So let's see what else I have here. Let's put it back to the way that he had it. I have those, which you could always mess with in some sort of way. I don't really care for these. When these are like this, it's kind of framing what's ever in it. Then that really draws your attention to it. Doing this, gosh dang it, doing this does not frame it as much. And then, you know, we have two blocks here, so it doesn't really work as well in this situation. So I'm going to say no to that. You could always do something like this. And I'm not a huge fan of that one either. And then I've also got gates, which is closest to what he had, and I think might be my preference to actually go with that over that, because it looks more like a support. I don't know, this doesn't look like a support to me. Have you ever seen a building that had two flat surfaces with a small pole inside of it? Because that doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. This makes more sense to me. So keeping like really close to what he's done, I like that more. But that's just me. And then down here, let's grab this. He does frame this doorway like this. This I like. I like using the fence as more of a post. Having a post up here doesn't make much sense because I don't know why you need a post right there. Right here, you could even get away with it right here and shove some chests or crates or whatever you want back there. I could even do something like this. See, now this is stuff that I'm learning from his techniques. I'm taking his techniques. I'm like, well, here's where I would put my spin on it. These are the touches that I would probably add if this were my build and I were at this point. But let's continue on looking at the things that he's done, see if there's anything else for us to learn. So I'm looking back at this picture, and I'm actually wrong on this, and this is interesting too. He actually brings this wall forward. I'll tell you why I think that's interesting in a moment when I get this right. So that's going to go there. That's going to go there. Our trapdoors are going to go back. And this is interesting because it creates twice as much depth as we have been using. So I think this pillar, yeah, this pillar is indeed going to come up this way, and then we're going to continue the theme of these, the stone stairs, and then the shape inside, framing the windows, very predictable, very simple. It's nothing there is varying. So these designs right here where the windows are vary from floor to floor, but for the most part he's not making any difference amongst each one of similar style. So what's interesting to me about this is, well, the bottom floor follows a path like this, like at a constant slope, well, nearly a constant slope. The top floor, or the middle floor, it is actually goes like this. And those are two pretty different shapes on top of each other. And he makes it work with this being under there. It's hard to see from these pictures, but I believe that's the location that he has these in. And it's probably the location that I would put them in. See, now this brings in another opportunity. Maybe for posts here, I'd have to do away with that. That would require something different. Just as it is, I didn't like that. But let's actually, just to keep in with his theme, I'm not sure if he did that. It's kind of hard to see in some places. But that creates varying depth. And the most important part is that this little thing is tucked away, which kind of takes away from you seeing it. It's like sort of like the least important part of the build, but it's not the least important. It's the least noticed part of the build. And that's something that I talk about a lot. That's really important. It's not one eye-catching thing that's important in a build in Minecraft. It's a bunch of things that are varying in degrees of being eye-catching, where this might be the first thing that you look at, but then your eye wanders and you see, oh, look at the second floor, look at the third floor that they have. Oh, look, this is tucked all the way behind there. And to capitalize on it, great decision by him. I don't know if he had the builder had the same thoughts as me, but he has this tiny little window on this one that to me is the least noticeable wall. I think that just kind of adds to the point that this wall is kind of in the shadow of the rest of the build, but that's a good thing. It gives a lot of depth. Funny enough, looking back, he actually does do that right there, just like I was saying. So I'm on the same wavelength as this builder, so he does it there as well. I'm not sure that I'm a huge fan of it right here, just because I don't really like the connected structure of the fence so much. I think I almost prefer it there. Or actually, in this case, I would do it here because he also has fence here. Now, again, this is kind of just one part of an assortment of in and out on this pillar right here. I think I would maybe even go without that right there. And I would maybe prefer, I wouldn't do that because then that boxes in this thing and I don't like that. What I maybe would do is something like that. No, I don't really like that either. I like the fact that this has its own little space right there with nothing interrupting it. Real quick note, I noticed that he wasn't afraid to put two pillars side by side right here. Sometimes it feels like that's a little bit clunky, like it's too much pillar, but it works really well here. So it looks like after having this wall on the same plane all the way up, he does switch it up once we get to the third floor. So what he does is he continues this decorative column of sorts of wood, all the same kind of wood, but really it's just in and out, varying by half a block, changing depth, just a lot of filler detail, really. And then it comes out like this. It's actually kind of hard to see here. It comes out quite a bit, actually. It comes out here and here, and now these are going to be ledges, flat edges. So there's going to be a window right here, and then looks like this is, I'm just going to place this for now, but I think that goes there. So this wall comes out one, and then he has this, which I've never been very keen on doing this myself, but he has some pots there. To me, it's like, okay, someone's in this house right here. Who the heck is reaching out here and putting flower pots on this ledge? But it's a little detail. You add plants there, and plants are always a good thing to add everywhere. He does have leaves going over some of these walls too. So it looks like this pattern is going to be continued in a similar manner, and I can't really see for sure, because some of these angles are hard to reach, but actually looks like he does one of these deals, and then it looks like, no, not lantern, let's go with a lamp, glowstone, let's go with a lamp. He is using a texture pack, and it looks like he might be using a head or something smaller than a full block that's textured to be a lamp, but he does have something like that. And I kind of want to stray from that just because these are very big. And they're, as it is now, it's almost a little too eye-catching to me. I would almost not even be afraid to put torches here on the end, but probably not that either. So let's see what else he continues to do. So just from what I've learned from him, I'm not even looking at his build. I'm going to say that he probably brought this up and probably did one of these deals and probably did this. I'm going to look back and it's similar, but he actually pulls a tricky one on us here on the fourth floor. He goes like that and then quickly goes into this, which is capped off. By the way, these I think would look fine without. The end of logs are different enough that I think it's good enough that way. But he does have it that way, and he does have better trapdoor texture, I think. I don't care for these trapdoor textures. But he does this again, which allows him to do the roof in an interesting way. Now, this is where I thought maybe he's going to pull out the wall like this, right? Or keep the wall on this angle, or possibly even pull out the wall like that somehow. And he doesn't. What he does is really cool. So we've brought out the wall looking from the side like that. And what he does is see if I'm looking at this the right way. He actually kind of sets this wall back a little bit. It's actually not back, but this the trim on the roof line is set forward enough. And I'm just gonna throw it into place. It's not gonna be exact, but it looks like he does some sort of deal like this. This is not exact. To me, this doesn't need to be exact. There's a lot of different ways that you can do these roof lines, and it kind of comes down to the individual house. And this is not too different from what I do, so I'm not going to spend too much time studying his specifically. But what he does do is he creates a shape like this, and then creates a different shape on the inside, which that I don't do. Normally, I would do just like that. This little whoop in right there, that's useful to me. I really like that. And then he sets in this wall like this. Now, at first glance, I thought that that was set back, and it's not. But after looking at all these details that he's done, I almost want to do it like this, where I'm going to take it, set everything back a block, and this is going to be tucked into the roof line. So it's going to be like you can't even see it when you're down below. So let's imagine that there's... Oh, let's grab some. Let's just say this is going to be our roof material and match the rest of the wood. So let's say our roof is like, our stone roof here didn't make much sense. I didn't do that very well. So let's just say our roof goes like that, right? And then our window would be set in here. So if I were to complete that roof, actually it would be right there. If I were to complete that roof, it would kind of hide that, and that would bring in another area like this, where it's kind of not the last thing that you focus on. You might focus on the roof line, but the thing actually tucked into it seems pretty unimportant, and it's not your eye's priority when you're focusing on different things. Now, here's a new trick that I've learned. I put in the basic shape of the roof here. Normally, I would do this, and I'd look at it, and I'd be disappointed in myself. I've done this before, because I'm like, I feel like something could go here, and he found something to go there. He actually, I think what I'm about to do is different than what he does. I think he put this right over the window like that, and then did this, which looks really good, I think. Alternatively, you could go like... Let's just put this back. You could bring it out and put a log right there. So it's going to bring in different levels of depth. That's actually dark enough that you can hardly even tell that that's brought out, because it just looks like darkness. But that is tucked away in there. See how much darker that is? If I were to have higher shaders on too, that would be just that much more dramatic. And I do like that being tucked away. Real quick, let's go over this. He actually transitions from having three wide window spaces here, so he's working with odds, to having a 2x2 window, which I don't care for the actual window itself here. And I actually screwed this up a little. It looks like what he does is he has this, like he always does, and then he has the 2x2 window. And I'm not a huge fan of the window itself, but it does break up. It breaks it up in a way that if I built this and I did that right now and I step back, I would probably say, no, if I'm going to have to reduce this window size, then I'm going to reduce it even more, bring that pillar over there. But odds can be good. I think the way that he actually tucks it in turns out to be pretty good. So what he does here, I'm going to take this stairway here, and I think I'm lining this up right. He makes a little roof line like this, and now it's tucked away. So this is another example of being an unimportant, or rather less attractive, less eye-catching feature, it's going to be tucked in, and now this is going to be brought up, I'm assuming. I'm not even looking, but I'm pretty sure that that's brought up. And then something might happen here. You could do something like that, because that doesn't seem right. Otherwise, where's my trapdoors? There you are. Yeah, I think that's about what he does. But he brings in this second roof line, and I am kind of straying from the way that he builds now, which is good. I've kind of learned his tricks, and I'm like, look, I can build this without this guy's help. Like, that's fine. It's probably not exactly what he had, but it is in the style that he's doing. Let's add in a wall right here just to be complete. So, again, he adds in a second roof line right there. And then he does this thing right here that tucks away this weird window that I'm kind of meh on. It does change things up, but it feels a little out of place. And then he does one of these deals. So this looks like it's going to come wrap around like this. And it's going to take some fence. And this is part that I really like. I think this really, really brings the build together. No, I don't want that. I want full spruce blocks. There's a walkway up here, an area that looking at the picture, it looks like there would be a door right around here, and then walls. So there's going to be like something like this, I'm guessing. No, let's put that back. And again, I can't see this area very well from the pictures. So it's going to be something like that. And you can walk out here. Now this adds so many levels of immersion to me. And he caps it off like that. That you can be walking around here. You can come in here, wander around this seemingly large, very large building. I mean, just looking at it, I imagine that there's multiple rooms here. Work your way up to a fourth floor, and then walk out a door, and you find yourself looking down at where you were. That's very important to me. So, again, looking back there, I'm not so sure I'm a big fan of this window, but this is something that I love. That's a trick that I want to use. So, and he does some sort of deal, like, I don't know, he flattens out the roof line like this or something like that, then continues it so that you can actually walk here. You could even do something like this. I'm not sure if that's what he has. No, it's not. In fact, now that I'm looking at it, he has his walkway come all the way up to this roof line. I'm curious how he does this. So the way that he does it, he's going to have a lot bigger space than I do, actually. What he's going to do is let's just grab full blocks. He's probably using half slabs here. Actually, let's do half slabs. Let's not be lazy on this. If I were doing the real thing, I wouldn't be lazy on this. And then he does it like that, and that's a lot of walk space back there that you've given yourself now, which is important. A lot of times you're building on such a small scale that if you want some sort of balcony like this, it's just like a 2x3 area, and it's really not very big. This is a big area, actually. When you walk out here, you give yourself space to put some clutter detail over here. And you can see over, you're actually hanging over where you walk in. So that adds another very, very important. Ooh, this actually turns out very well looking at it. Let's get rid of that. This, I love this. So what this does is it tucks away that ugly little window a little bit more. And it's sticking out to me so much because there's stone brick behind it. If there were an interior behind it, it would be much darker. So let's actually try to simulate that. Just pretend that there's, you know, no daylight coming through. So now that I've blocked this off a little bit, it's not nearly as noticeable. And I like that a lot more. But this just tucks everything away. I think the power of tucking stuff underneath things is really important when you're building on a scale like this. So for the most part, this isn't entirely complete, but I feel like if I were to do the rest of it, there's like this right here, looking at the picture, this structure, this roof structure right here is pretty much duplicated, set a couple blocks further back right there. There's a window tucked in right here that is very similar to these, and then has a roof line, some sort of roof line that I can't really make out, something like this, but maybe a little bit more complicated. And then the window. And then it has a, I think this is important, it has a roof going, not this way, but like this. And that gives him the opportunity to put windows into the roof line there. And then, you know, obviously that's not really where it would, something more like that. Obviously it wouldn't just be flat with that wall there. And so at this point, I feel like if I completed what I see, for the most part, it would be repeating myself, so I'm not going to. But then there's little details I can't really make out. But I think I've learned a lot here. So the things that I really got from this was how to work with the ins and outs of depth on a one, when you only want to use one block to do it without flipping back and forth with your entire wall. So your entire wall structure, see the entire wall structure switches here. When he does it here and then there, it makes it more dramatic there, right? So small here, big here for a more dramatic effect. If I were to do a similar type thing where this was maybe set back, and this could probably look fine set back, just to be honest, but I think it kind of amplifies the impact of it when it's set out a whole block higher up, and then you get that hanging effect, which, you know, let's put this in just to show you that I think it could work. Right there, and then this was here, and there, see, I almost prefer that. So like I said, the thing that I prefer to do, I think actually maybe could have been an improvement here. But, and then that just gives us, not as, it's slanted more technically, but because this is still the same, it's not real that impactful, but that's just like itty bitty little details that kind of makes it so it's not necessary to use these things that he does here. Or I almost like it more because these things aren't in line with these, which was kind of my main problem with that. It's like too much stuff on one surface, this nonsense that I'm not particularly keen on doing myself. I don't think it makes a whole lot of sense. You know, you can do something like that. I don't think I would, though, because looking at it straight on, it kind of takes away from this section and the fact that there's a little bit of wall there. You know, that's the kind of stuff that you notice that adds to a build. And then the power of having a overhang like this. So the other thing that I learned is that your wall lines from one floor to the other don't need to follow from one floor to the next. It can really differ like quite a bit and be very impactful. So that's my first shot at doing a build study. Hopefully you guys learned stuff. This is for those of you, I should have said that this at the beginning, but this is for those of you that really, you already know how to build, but you really want to learn other people's techniques. Maybe you build this whole thing, you only pick up one or two things. That's one or two more things that you can add to your game. That's important when you're a builder, I think. So I learned some things that's going to be important for my Let's Build series. Hopefully you learned some things that's going to be important for you. So thank you for watching, everybody. If you like it, then let me know. I'll do this more often, and see you then. Bye.